Do you know about the asteroid impact that caused the extinction of the dinosaurs? Well, today I'm going to tell you a similar story, further back in time, of an asteroid impact event that was even bigger. Join me, Val Aguilar, graduate student of geology at Harvard University, to uncover just what happened to the earliest life forms and the surface of the Earth billions of years ago. Along the way, you'll learn how scientists like me study this catastrophic event. So let's take a journey back in time. When you think about the very beginning of the history of the Earth, what times do you think of? Hundreds, thousands, maybe even millions of years ago? Try billions. Around 4.5 billion years, actually, which is when the planet Earth formed. To really understand just how long ago this is, let's do a quick exercise. Stretch your arms out wide, and imagine if the entire history of Earth, from its formation to now, were represented by the length of your arms. Dinosaurs roamed the Earth about 66 million years ago. Where do you think that falls? It would actually be right here, the edge of my finger knuckle. Surprised? What if I asked you to guess when humans came into the picture? We'd be just a tiny speck at the very end. If I filed my fingernails, all of humankind's history would vanish, from the first Homo sapiens to modern civilization. So when we talk about deep time, we're talking about billions of years. Time on a scale that's hard for our human brains to grasp, but that's what makes Earth's story so incredible. So you might be wondering, what was going on the rest of that time, even before the dinosaurs? Well, at first, billions of years ago, Earth was a hot mess, and it took a long time for things to cool down. And afterwards, the Earth underwent many changes. So let's jump to around 3.5 billion years ago, the time period that we'll be focusing on today. The ancient planet was a strange, almost otherworldly place with no plants or animals in sight. That's maybe unsurprising because we also know that there wasn't any oxygen around either. Believe it or not, the first life on Earth, microscopic organisms called bacteria and archaea, were alive and well in this mysterious world. Thinking more about what the Earth was like for the first signs of life sounds pretty crazy, right? Well, it gets crazier. Remember when I mentioned a giant asteroid that collided with the planet? Well, that happened at this time too. But hang on. How do we know what the Earth was like billions of years ago? And how do we know an asteroid impact even happened in the first place? It's not like we have a time machine, right? Well, we don't. But we do have rocks, which are sort of like time capsules that record events from the distant past. Geology, the study of rocks, is based on the idea that the same natural processes shaping the Earth today have been at work throughout its history. For instance, wave ripples seen on beach sands today and rocks that have wave ripple patterns suggest there were similar processes in the past when it was formed. This rock represents a beach environment. This is one way that geologists, or scientists that study rocks, identify ancient environments. Think of it as the present is the key to the past. When these beach sands, for example, get buried under new beach sands, they eventually harden into a sedimentary rock over time. Due to the rock cycle, you eventually get many rock layers on top of each other. We call the study of these rock layers stratigraphy. Hang on, the cake is ready. I made some sweet treats to show you what I mean. I've baked 4 different flavors of cake: chocolate, coffee, peanut butter, and vanilla. I'm going to start my cake with chocolate as the first layer. Then I'll stack this coffee cake layer next. Now I'll put down a peanut butter layer, and finally I'll add this vanilla cake layer last, topped with frosting, of course. Now that I cut a slice, you can see all the layers together in one finished product. You just saw me make this cake, right? But what if you didn't? If you only saw this one slice, could you figure out the order of which layer got there first and which arrived last? Probably, right? Logically, the chocolate layer at the bottom is the oldest one. It had to be there before anything else. And the vanilla layer at the top was added most recently. It's the youngest layer. So just as we can tell the order of cake layers, geologists can tell the sequence of rock layers using stratigraphy. Like each cake layer has a distinct flavor, each rock layer has a distinct clue about its environment. Many layers together can tell us the order of events to understand how an environment changes through time. This is how scientists, like me, reconstruct the past. Now, remember, I study rocks that are extremely old, billions of years, right? So in theory, they're pretty much at the bottom of Earth's layers, probably way too far for us to find, right? Not always. Other natural processes, like earthquakes, can sometimes bring these old rock layers to the surface as mountains. So where are these ancient mountains? There are only a handful of places on Earth where rocks this old are possible for humans to find. As a geologist, I've traveled to some of the most remote places in the world, like the Australian outback. This is one of the oldest pieces of land on Earth. Here, there are rocks that are about 3.5 billion years old. This is me in Australia. I find these rare rocks and study the stratigraphy closely by measuring the thickness of the rock layers and interpreting what environment they might represent. Then I take a heavy hammer to collect rock samples to bring back home with me. This is the really fun part, but you do have to learn to be a little tough to break them and then carry them in your backpack down a mountain. Once the rocks and I are back at Harvard, I prepare small portions of rocks for analysis and examine them closely using a variety of laboratory techniques. This is me using a microscope. You might be wondering, what does geologic evidence of a huge asteroid impact event look like? Here is a 3.5 billion-year-old rock that I collected from Australia. This special rock is evidence of an asteroid impact event because of a really unique feature that you might need a magnifying glass to see. You can see these small, white-colored, circular shapes. They're called spherules, and they're evidence of a huge impact because they represent the fallout, or what literally falls out of the atmosphere. So what do I mean by that? We theorize that a huge asteroid, up to 30 miles wide, slammed into Earth 3.5 billion years ago. You're probably familiar with the three phases of matter: solids, liquids, gas, right? Well, this huge collision created intense pressure and heat, causing a rare reaction. Instead of rock melting into liquid lava like you might expect, both the asteroid and the Earth's land vaporized instantly. That means the rock went from its original solid phase, skipped the liquid lava phase, and passed directly to the gas phase, producing vaporized rock. This vapor, a mixture of space and Earth rock gases, spread rapidly through the atmosphere, forming a massive hot cloud that blocked out the sun around the world. As the cloud reached the outer atmosphere into the cold temperatures of space, the gas cooled and quickly condensed back into a solid form as glass. These tiny beads of glass took the shape of perfect spheres because they were floating in the zero gravity of space. Eventually, most fell back to the Earth due to Earth's gravitational pull. For months, maybe even years, the sky rained out beads of glass. Imagine seeing that? The glass balls landed everywhere on Earth, eventually becoming buried in sand and mud over time underneath other layers, and these became the spherules that are now encased in rock and hold the story of this catastrophic event. So my job is to identify the spherules and look at other rock evidence, like what the stratigraphy records above the spherules, to find out what happened to the environment after this disaster. Earthquakes, tsunamis, worldwide darkness, climate change. I study the stratigraphy to figure out what extreme conditions happened, how long they lasted, and how they might have affected life on Earth. Clearly, there were microscopic survivors after this catastrophic event, because you and I and all the other life on Earth is around today. Life just always seems to find a way. Figuring out the conditions of Earth after this impact event can be used to figure out how life in the past evolved to become so resilient, and what kind of life may exist in other extreme environments across the universe. In a lot of ways, the past is the key to the future. So, if traveling the world, being outdoors, and acting as an Earth detective seems interesting, then geology might just be for you. There are so many mysteries about this planet just sitting underneath our feet, ready to be discovered. Thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you learned something cool. See you next time.